Live coming up in just a bit.
Command in order to be effective.
So we're getting set for baseball. A couple of national anthems coming up. Wayne Mesmer with the duties, our Canadian national anthem, followed by the U.S. national anthem.
To honor Canada and the United States, we ask that you all please rise and kindly remove your caps and join along with me, Chicago Cubs public address announcer Wayne Mesmer, accompanied by Gary Pressey at the Wrigley Field Lowry organ, in a singing and playing of O Canada, followed by the Star-Spangled Banner. O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of
Chicago Cubs baseball, brought to you by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. The Illinois Lottery. No matter how you play, play the Illinois Lottery. Have a ball. Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League.
Win on his homestand and avoid the sweep. And exchanging the lineup cards, the Spires. Chris Spire, the Cubs third base coach, and Justin Spire, right-hander for the Blue Jays, and a 55th round pick of the Cubs back in 95. Appeared in one game for the Cubs in 1998 before getting traded to Florida, and he has not yet appeared in this series. And today's game being presented in high definition and also in Dolby Digital 5.1 audio where available. Let's check out John Gibbons' Blue Jays lineup. Reed Johnson in there again today, as you see his numbers in this series, playing in right field for the first time in the series. Frank Catalanato out at left. Vernon Wells is center fielder. Eric Hinsky returning to his original organization, at least this ballpark. So his first start in this series. Aaron Hill, the third baseman, Hudson, Adams, Huckabee, and Halladay round out the Blue Jays lineup.
Here's how the Cubs take the field defensively. Brought to you by Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs. One minor change, Todd Hollandsworth in right field today. Jason Dubois in left, Corey Patterson in center. Ramirez, Perez, Walker, and Lee across the infield. Michael Barrett, one of the offensive stars of the game last night for the Cubs, with a couple of home runs behind the plate for right-hander Sergio Mitre. A lot of the Blue Jays were trying to get a scouting report on Sergio Mitre before the ball game today. That's one of the hazards of interleague play. You're just not as familiar with your opponent as you are with teams that you face during the regular season. And as we mentioned in the open, Mitre needs to be perfect with his command today, especially with that breaking ball.
And the arbiters today, the crew chief Dale Scott is back at the plate. Cheetah, Culpa, and Iasonia around the bases.
There's a nice touch with the lineup cards today. Both Spires going out to home plate. You may wonder why the manager doesn't do that every day. A lot of it just has to do with superstition and trying to either maintain your luck or change your luck. If one of the coaches takes out the lineup card one day and you happen to win a ball game, there's a real good chance he's going to take out the lineup card again the next day.
88 degrees here at game time. Wind is blowing out slightly right now. And it'll be Reed Johnson, who's 8-for-19 with a triple and four home runs against the Cubs in five career games. Ramirez in at third. Mitre ready to work. And we're underway. Two starts ago, Sergio gave up six runs in five and a third. He got a no decision. The Cubs beat the Rockies 11-6. His last time out, his first loss, five innings and four and two thirds at San Diego. That's a strike and a fastball, and it's 1-1. So Mitre making his fourth start. The wind and the pitch hit hard on the ground, knocked down by Ramirez, has some time, and throws out Johnson. So a good start defensively for the Cubs. It was not a banner night last night for the Cubs defense. Two errors made in that game, and they were both critical ones.
Ramirez does what he has to do. He was playing in to take the bunt away from Johnson. That ball was hit hard just a little bit to his right. Just smothered it, knocked it down, had plenty of time to find the ball and get the out at first base.
Ball one to Frank Catalanato.
It's that old Ron Santo theory. We'll talk about it all season long. Santo says all you need at third base is a strong chest and a strong arm.
Well, the Cubs last night with two throwing errors leading to unearned runs. Right now tied for 12th in the National League in fielding percentage. 2-0 the count on Catalanato, who's 7 for his last 12. He has kept a black book, a black binder, with all of his at-bats in the big leagues, and actually started doing it on opposing pitchers in Double-A when he was in the Tigers organization. Larry Parrish was his manager at that time and suggested, why don't you keep a log of your at-bats? So he still does it. And I said, well, what do you do with a guy like Mitre you haven't seen? He said, I look at the video. And he said, I only look at a guy against left-handed hitters. Bounced to short. That's Nathy Perez. And he throws him out. You'll appreciate this, Bob. I said, you ever put it on a computer? Make it a little easier? He goes, no, I've had a lot of people ask me if they could do that for me. He says, I like to write it out myself.
Yeah, you know, when you write things down by hand, you tend to remember them a little bit more. And it certainly has worked for Catalanato, a 296 lifetime hitter in the big leagues.
See, the perspiration looks like he's already played nine innings.
Oh, this is the kind of day you can get loose shaking hands. Very hot, muggy day here. Good for baseball.
Six-game hitting streak for Vernon Wells. Two doubles, an RBI, and a walk last night. Went 2-for-4 in the opener, so he's had a good series. Good location on the outside edge. And it's 1-1. pitch. 2-1. Mitre facing the Blue Jays for the first time. Roy Halladay battling the Cubs for the first time, although several Cubs have had previous at-bats against Halladay with other teams.
A little chin music here to Vernon Wells. I think that's something the Cubs pitching staff has not done enough of in this series. I don't think this is intentional. I don't think he meant to throw it up near the head. But these Blue Jays hitters have been leaning out over the plate, taking outside strikes and lining them into right field. Gotta do something to keep them honest. Can't let them hang out over that plate.
So a full count on Vernon Wells. 13 home runs on the year. Here's a pitch. And Mitre with a 1-2-3 first inning. Couple of ground outs and a strikeout. Cubs coming up. Walker and Dubois in the middle. Todd Hollandsworth getting the start, but in right field, Jeremy Burnett's with the day off. Only the second time he hasn't started this year. Barrett and Mitre make up the battery.
Take a look at the Blue Jays defensively. Catalanato in left, Wells in center, Johnson in right field today. Hill at third base, Adams at short, Hudson at second base, Eric Hinsky, one-time Cubs draft pick at first base. Ken Huckabee, a real good catch and throw guy, has thrown out 7 of 8 attempted base stealers this year. And Roy Halladay, the big right-hander on the mound, 9-2 record this season, as I mentioned earlier, leads the American League with 92 innings pitched, 4 complete games. This guy is the real deal. Has allowed 3 runs in his last 5 starts, all victories.
So it's Nathy Perez who's hitting .389 for his last 16 games. And a fastball for a strike from Halladay. Halladay, 28 years old, 6'6", 225, first round pick in 95, and he's been terrific lately. He had a strained oblique that bumped back his start 2 starts ago, backed it up 3 days, then came back, pitched a 2-hit shutout. And if he hadn't been bumped back, he would not have pitched in this series, and he was very excited about pitching here at Wrigley Field for the first time.
Well, as far as the Cubs are concerned, that makes one of them.
That's right.
Excited to see Roy Halladay.
Outside, and it's 2-2. Yeah, the 2 hits he gave up against the Twins were both infield hits in the complete game shutout a couple of starts ago. No walks, 10 strikeouts. That is a foul ball. Good play by Aaron Hill to go get it. But into foul territory, and a quick call by Dan Iasonia. Chris Spire asking, and I think Chris was too impressed with the call. He thought it was fair.
Home plate umpire Dale Scott was nodding his head to Dan Iasonia and indicating that he got the call right. Well, I don't know. It looked like it went right over the bag from that angle. Nice play by Aaron Hill down there to flag that ball down, but I do not believe they were going to get Nathy Perez. You don't see Chris Spire get too upset down there unless he's pretty sure he's right.
Ground ball to Hudson. And that'll bring up Corey Patterson.
Tied for first in the American League with his 9 victories. Third in ERA, third in opponent's batting average. Tied for first with his 2 shutouts among his 4 complete games. He's a little bit different pitcher now than he was a couple of years ago. Had a couple of stints on the DL last season with shoulder problems. Missed almost 2 months. From July 20th to September 21st with shoulder problems. He's lowered his arm angle just a little bit. Gets a little more sink on the ball now than he used to.
Strike 1 on Patterson. Corey had an eventful night in the outfield last night. Had 1 bad throw leading to a run and 1 great throw. Erasing Vernon Wells late in the ball game. He was trying to stretch a double into a triple. Mentioned a couple of throwing errors for the Cubs. Nathy Perez with 1 in the 9th as the Blue Jays added an extra run. Here comes Halladay. He strikes out Patterson for out number two.
Yeah, really, the Nathan Perez error last night was unfortunate because the ball was hit between third and short. As you get a look at strike three to Patterson here, sinking fastball down and away. Ramirez had gone to his left to try to make a play on the ground ball. Perez was going to his right. The runner was going from second to third. If Ramirez had been able to retreat to the bag in time, they could have taken the easy out at third base, but Ramirez was way too far away from the bag for Nathan to make a play and immediately pointed to first base to let him know that the play was across the infield. Nathan had to make an off-balance throw, unfortunately went in the dirt.
Derek leading the National League in average and home runs, second in RBIs. 2-for-8 in this series. Another Lee Carlos of the Milwaukee Brewers leading the National League in RBIs. Well, you mentioned that strikeout pitch against Corey Patterson. A sinking fastball from Halladay at 95. Really almost an impossible pitch to hit. Bounced over the mound, charging is Russ Adams. Throw to first is in time to get Lee. Each team with a 1-2-3 first. We'll head to the second. Nothing.
Hey, watch this.
You want some of this? You like banana?
Oh, good. Yeah. Here, take it. Seriously. Go.
No score, second inning. Watch live Cubs games right on your computer. Sign up for MLB.TV now exclusively at Cubs.com. MLB.TV means live baseball. No score, and Eric Hinsky will lead off the second. This is his first start in the series. John Gibbons went with a predominantly right-handed hitting lineup against two left-handed starters to begin this series. That's a fair ball. Lee spins, throws to Mitre covering first for out number one. And Hinsky grew up in Menasha, Wisconsin, actually rooted for the Cubs, and of course was drafted by the Cubs, eventually traded to the Oakland A's, but they're excited to get in the lineup today. Mitre getting over to first in plenty of time, and that'll bring up Aaron Hill. Left side of the Blue Jays infield, manned by rookies, Russ Adams, a shortstop, and Aaron Hill, the third baseman. Hill with two game-winning RBIs in this series. Talked about all the RBIs for him. 18 games, 17 RBIs. Well, he's hitting .579 with runners in scoring position. That'll rack up those RBIs in a hurry.
Well, there's something to be said for that. You know, certain players just seem to be able to rise to the occasion with runners in scoring position. They put together their best at bats. I think back to former Blue Jay and former Cub George Bell.
Ramirez scoops it up. Four ground ball outs here early on for Mitre.
George Bell was one of those guys that just seemed to have that knack for putting together great at-bats with runners in scoring position. Of course, by the time the Cubs got him, he was on the downside of his career and wasn't nearly as successful in those situations as he was in his heyday with the Blue Jays.
Two outs, nobody on, and it's Orlando Hudson, a switch batter, and a .289 left-handed, under a .150 right-handed, so you can see why Frank Menachino got a couple of starts at second against the lefties earlier in this series. Hudson a lot better left-handed than right-handed in his career.
You see the numbers Len was talking about. I think a lot of that is due to the fact that from that left-handed batter's box, he's a step and a half closer to first base, and he's got the kind of speed that can beat out infield hits with regularity.
Well, Sergio Mitre has already faced Roger Clemens, Adam Eaton, and now Roy Halladay is going to have to get over to first again, but Lee says, that's okay, I'll take it myself. Six up, six down for Mitre. No score early on.
Tonight, Entertainment Weekly is in love with Ashton Kutcher's social experiment, Beauty and the Geek.
Bust, waist, and hips.
The New York Times calls it a winner.
Is this the butt floss?
Ew.
Ashton Kutcher's show has heart.
All these guys are like some of the greatest guys I've ever met.
It's the funniest reality show in ages.
How about this? Wait, isn't this one a move too?
Oh my God.
Beauty and the Geek.
Tonight at 7 on WGN, Chicago's WB.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Chevy, turn the key and start a revolution.
Chevy's proud to be the number one selling passenger car brand. We have...
Hey, Cubs fans, if you hit our WGN baseball blog brought to you by Dunkin' Donuts, well, on the blog today, I have a post about the current state of affairs with the Cubs. Some great shots from our recent West Coast road trip. Bob handicaps a Cubs swing through interleague play. And it has been a struggle for the Cubs. 1-4 through the first five games in interleague play. I don't know if that'll keep you cool or not today, that hat, but keep giving it a shot. One strike on Aramis Ramirez.
I think there's any pictures of Alyssa Milano on there from our West Coast swing?
Probably. Maybe the empty seats. The game she did not attend.
Now that hot dog was raw when he got to the ballpark today.
Pulled down the left field line by Ramirez and out of play. Well, when you have a matchup like this, I would assume you'd want the wind to blow out, try to mitigate Roy Halladay a little bit. And if the Cubs can get some fly balls with some power in the air, they're going to hit some home runs today.
Halladay has given up 7 home runs. Not an extraordinary number of home runs, but you get one up today, it definitely will go to left field.
And Mitre has looked very sharp in his first two innings. The 1-2. And a nice play by Aaron Hill. Dropped it for a lot of time. Played that short hop. Able to throw out Ramirez.
Once again, at third base, you don't always have to field it cleanly. You just keep that ball in front of you. The ground ball gets down there so quickly that you know you have plenty of time. If you can just keep your wits about yourself, don't panic. You still have plenty of time to make the play, and Hill did a nice job.
26 previous at-bats for Todd Walker against Roy Halladay. 7 hits and a home run in those 26 at-bats. The 0-1 pitch. Flared foul and just out of play. Well, you know this very well, Bob, as anyone. I mean, you look at a series on paper. He had a couple of rookie left-handers Monday night. Last night, on paper, advantage Cubs. Glendon Rush had pitched so well, and Josh Towers had scuffled. Neither starter figured in the decision. But you look at it today, Halladay against Mitre, but it doesn't always work out the way it's, quote, supposed to.
Well, yeah, that old cliche, you don't play the game on paper. You have to actually go out there on the field and get 27 outs and score more runs than the other guy to win a ball game. And, you know, anything can happen. I mean, Sergio Mitre is capable of jumping up and pitching a great ball game. So far, keeping the ball down well, getting ground balls. I think the biggest thing is going to be taking advantage of any opportunities that are presented to the Cubs offensively today by Roy Halladay. He doesn't give up a lot, so when you do get base runners on base, you really have to execute the fundamentals of the game.
Walker strikes out. That's K number 2 for Halladay. And it brings Jason Dubois to the plate.
This is another change in Halliday's arsenal. He doesn't throw his curveball nearly as hard as he used to. It used to be a big 12-6 breaker. He'd started at the left shoulder of a right-handed hitter and sweep it all the way across the plate and down at the knees on the outside corner. He's taken a little bit off of that pitch. It's a little more controlled now. He's able to keep it around the strike zone more often.
One strike on Dubois. Jason's last home run came against the White Sox in interleague play on May 22nd. He has 5 on the year. So first time he and Hollandsworth have both been in the lineup. Holly is on deck and he's in right field today. So Jeremy Burnett's with a day off. Cubs have their first off day in about 3 weeks tomorrow. So Dusty wanted to give Burnett's 2 full days off before that big series against the Red Sox starting Friday. And In the first 19 of this stretch of 20 straight without an off day, the Cubs are 12-7. Here comes Halladay again. There's a bouncer to Hill. Both offenses very quiet through two. Still nothing, nothing.
Nice.
Hey, there's some Bud Light.
Hey, how about a Bud Light?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real.
Another Bud Light?
Sure.
It's all here.
Honda Accord wasn't designed to start you like this. I know a girl with a golden touch. The Toyota Camry wasn't designed with a view like this. She's got enough, she's got too much. The Nissan Altima 2.5 wasn't designed, but designed for action.
On the WB Friday night, it's a Reba that goes back in time to solve a mystery.
Who?
You!
One whole day.
What?
It's a classic whodunit.
No fair, there's no one to the left of me.
Reba,
Friday night at 8 on WGN, Chicago's WB. Moving Forward is Motor Trend's 2005 Truck of the Year. Moving Forward is an excellent value. And Moving Forward is getting a great value on any of Toyota's award winners at the Toyota Sales Drive. Visit your Toyota dealer now for incredible 0% financing or $1,500 cash back on a new 4Runner or a new Tundra. Hurry for great selection, outstanding values, and award-winning quality at the Toyota Sales Drive. Now that's Moving Forward. Toyota.
WGN Sports coverage of Cubs baseball from Wrigley Field is brought to you by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. Bud Light. No score as we start the third. No base runners. Thus far, Mitre and Halladay have both pitched extremely well. And bottom three for the Blue Jays, Adams, Huckabee, and Halladay. Adams, a left-handed swinging shortstop. Strike one from Mitre. Now that's more like it if you want to keep the sun away today. The 0-1 is inside, 1-1. Blue Jays now 4-5 on their 13-game road trip. They'll have an off day tomorrow. They'll play the Astros in Houston this weekend. Both teams three games over 500 entering play today. I think that might surprise some Cubs fans who don't watch a lot of the American League. This Blue Jays club fifth in the league in runs. Two pitch and look out, hit foul, and luckily there's a barrier in front of the dugouts. That ball would have smoked somebody in the Blue Jays dugout without the little fence in front.
Well, Toronto's a little bit like the ugly stepchild of that American League East with the Yankees and the Red Sox and the Orioles, with the acquisitions they had in the offseason. Everybody kind of overlooks the Blue Jays, but they've got a solid team, a lot of young players that have a ways to go before they're established big leaguers, but they're doing a lot of things well. They play great defense, second fewest errors in the American League. Only the Rangers have made fewer errors. They swing the bats well. They've got a strong rotation, a very well-balanced bullpen.
They're trying to hang around in that American League East, 4.5 out. Ken Huckabee 0 for his last 17. He's hitting just 122. He's a backup to Greg Zahn. He's thrown out 8 of 9 would-be base stealers. So it's a defense to talk about. Ken Huckabee. Chop to Ramirez. He's had a busy start to his afternoon. his fourth assist already.
It's a good sign that Mitre has that fastball sinking, keeping it down low in the strike zone. When you see a lot of right-handed hitters rolling over that pitch and hitting easy ground balls to the left side, that's a good indication that Mitre has a good sinker today.
First at bat this year for Roy Halladay, 1-for-24 in his career. No walks, 9 strikeouts. Another ground ball, Todd Walker to Derek Lee. First time through the order, nothing doing for the Blue Jays.
Maybe this isn't the best time to say it, but I think you're really beautiful.
Well, I've always been attracted to you too, Paul.
Wait, hold on one sec, babe. Excuse me?
Wanna get away? Now you can. Fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to select cities in the Midwest for just $49 one way. Give your gas card a break and fly Southwest Airlines.
You are now free to move about the country.
The extra mile? Sure, it's a state of mind. But with our minds guiding us, why not go further? Why not design a midsize sedan with a 235-horsepower V6 and lead the class in standard safety features? That way, when others mention an extra mile, we'll ask, why stop at just one? The all-new 2006 Sonata, a Hyundai like you've never seen before.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Hyundai, driven by a commitment to quality that lets them offer America's best warranty. Walgreens, the pharmacy of the Chicago Cubs. Your local Chicagoland Mercedes-Benz dealers. And by your local Honda dealers.
Over 10,000 patents. 119 years of automotive innovation. 66 years of safety testing. But only one Mercedes-Benz summer event. Now through August 1st, the one to remember. See your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer for special lease offers through Mercedes-Benz Credit on select C, E, and S-Class models.
Bottom three, no score. Visit the new Cubs clubhouse shop located on the 7th floor of Water Tower Place at 835 North Michigan Avenue here in Chicago. The Cubs clubhouse carries the widest selection of apparel, memorabilia, and Cubs gifts for the entire family. Still no base runners in this one. Cubs bat here in the third inning. Sun not a factor right now, but still a very warm afternoon. And the pitch to Todd Hollandsworth is hit down the left field line. That ball deep for him. It'll kick into the corner. First base runner, it's a double for Hollandsworth.
It's a fastball up, one of the few mistakes Halladay has made in the early going of this ball game. That pitch was up around the letters, out over the plate. Hollandsworth just stays with it, drives it down that left field line. This is one of those opportunities we talked about earlier. Have to find a way to advance Hollandsworth to third base here, if not drive him in. Michael Barrett be looking to shoot the ball to the right side. Even with the pitcher coming up next, you have to take advantage of every out you have against Halladay.
And Barrett drives that ball left center field. It'll be caught by Catalanato. Hollandsworth did not tag. He'll end up back at second. That ball was hit very well by Barrett. Michael with two home runs last night. And a loud out there in his first at bat today. So it'll be Mitre with one out, runner at second.
You know, Len, I used to have arguments with Joe Garagiola Sr. down in Arizona about the idea of productive outs, and he was of a mind that it's either an out or it's not an out. There's no such thing as a good out, but that was a non-productive out right there. Even though Michael Barrett hit the ball very hard, hit it to the gap in left center field, the runner's still at second base. You weren't able to advance him. Now, Michael Barrett has been swinging the bat extremely well lately. You don't want to give up an out necessarily with Michael, but would have been nice if he's going to be retired to at least find a way to get that runner from second to third base, in my eyes, making it a productive out.
Fair ball for Mitre. Hollandsworth will trot home Mitre on his way to second with his first career RBI. Boy, what a start to this one for Mitre. He hasn't given up anything on the mound, and he just ripped a double into the left field corner.
An unlikely offensive hero. Once again, another pitch up around the belt from Halladay. Man, that is a nice swing by Sergio Mitre. Keeps that ball just inside the line.
His second career double. His first career RBI, and it comes against a former Cy Young winner.
Well, when your pitchers hit doubles with runners on second base, you don't need productive outs from the eight hitter.
So the Cubs lead 1-0. And it's their first lead in this series. That one way outside to Napier.
Just a bit outside. That ball was headed for the backstop. Looked like a breaking ball that just slipped out of Halladay's hand. I don't know how Ken Huckabee caught that ball. Yeah, we've seen some mistakes here in this inning. He's gotten a lot of fastballs up over the heart of the plate. There's another one right there. Napier popping it to the left side.
And it is Adams colliding with Hill, but he makes a catch and foul ground.
Tough play for Hill. You can see the angle that he had on that ball. A much easier play for the shortstop. Adams either didn't call for that ball or Hill didn't hear him call for the ball, but he was able to hold on after the collision.
So it took until the third inning of game three and against the Blue Jays' best pitcher for the Cubs to have their first advantage here in this series. Now Patterson, who struck out on a nasty 95 mile an hour sinker in the first inning.
And we were talking after that first inning that Kevin Brown in his heyday, that's what that sinker looked like. Kevin Brown used to throw his in the mid to upper 90s with a lot of downward movement. Halladay at times can throw a very similar type of a sinker.
The middle and into center. Mitre will score. Patterson with a two out RBI single on an 0-2 pitch. And it's 2-0.
Wow, go figure. You've got the 7, 8, 9 hitters coming up against one of the best pitchers in the American League, and you end up scoring a couple of runs. Ball right back through the box. Halladay, normally a very sure-handed fielder, but that ball got on him quickly and took kind of a funny hop right at the end.
And Patterson running. Here's a throw by Huckabee, and Huckabee had no prayer. Corey got a great jump against Halladay and has his 8th stolen base. Dusty talked with Corey and Jerry Hairston yesterday about being more aggressive on the bases.
Boy, there's no catcher in the world going to throw out a base runner when you get a jump like that. Halladay just didn't pay any attention to Corey Patterson over there at first base.
Meanwhile, one ball, no strikes on Lee. Here's the pitch. And a breaking ball for a strike. D. Lee. Represented out in the bleachers. Side out swing, and he fouled it away down the right field line. Sergio Mitre, his first career RBI, it was a double, and then he scored on the Patterson single. Called strike three. So Lee is out. The Cubs done in the third inning, but they get two runs a pitcher in the middle of all of it. 2-0.
The Nissan All-
Ultima 2.5 wasn't designed with this much for action.
Hey, I'm late for this award show. Can I get a ride?
Come on, hop in. I tell you, Carson, the excitement here is tremendous.
Look at that. I didn't know P. Diddy drove a Diet Pepsi truck.
Don't scratch it.
All right, this is how I roll.
Hey, yo, P! Check out my new ride.
Moving Forward is a 41 miles per gallon highway rating. Moving Forward is an SUV with the lowest fuel cost in its class. Moving Forward is a great value on any of Toyota's fuel-efficient vehicles at the Toyota Sales Drive, now at your Toyota dealer. See 9 Toyota models with EPA highway ratings of 30 or more miles per gallon. So hurry for outstanding values at the Toyota Sales Drive. Now that's moving forward. Toyota.
On the WB Friday, Fran's dressing to impress for her boyfriend's high school reunion.
You look amazing.
You don't think the dress is too tight?
Not if you're a superhero.
And she's gonna turn a few heads.
This is Fran, my girlfriend.
Dude!
I know!
Living with Fran, Friday night at 8:30 on WGN.
2-0 Cubs. Let's pause briefly for station ID.
You're watching Chicago's official summer baseball station, WGN.
Len and Bob with you today from Wrigley Field, and Sergio Mitre, first time through the order against the Blue Jays, 8 ground ball outs and a strikeout. RBI double and a run scored for him as well. So facing Reed Johnson for the second time. 1 ball, no strikes.
Yeah, obviously very happy that Sergio Mitre was able to drive home a run with the double, then score a run on the Patterson single, but a little concerned how that may affect him as he goes back out to pitch this next half inning.
...24-year-old righty delivers a strike on the swing and the miss. Mitre, 6'4", 210 pounds. And Johnson bunts through, strike two. It's 2-2. Eventually, guys, Mitre has faced Clemens in his first start this year. Also faced left-hander Jeff Francis. Last time out, Adam Eaton beat Mitre for his 8th win. Well, today facing a 9-game winner. Just the luck of the draw sometimes. And he strikes him out. 10 up, 10 down for Mitre.
Well, so far, no ill effects from running the bases and driving in a run. Look at the movement on this sinker. I mean, and late movement, when it gets into the hitting zone, that's when it drops the most. You're seeing a lot of swings and misses and a lot of Blue Jay hitters just hitting the very top part of the ball, putting it in play weakly. Great movement.
Strike on Catalanato. The 0-1 pitch, that got his attention, and it's 1-1. There were some attention getters in the Red Sox Cardinals game last night. The Astros Mets as well. Some tempers flaring. Tapped Mitre with the toss to lead.
Another topped ball. Just beats it down into the ground in front of home plate. The toughest part of this play is getting it over the runner. That's where it helps to have a 6'5" first baseman just throw it up high. You know Derek Lee's going to get it.
And Sergio coming into this start as a major leaguer, 2-6 with a 6.87 ERA and 18 games, 14 starts. So this is his 15th career start. One and nothing on Wells. Here's the next pitch. A strike. But pretty simple. I mean, not only the movement, but Mitre getting ahead of the hitters. Makes it a lot easier when you're 0-1, 0-2, 1-1, 1-2. Now two balls and a strike.
Talked about those hit by pitch in that Boston St. Louis game last night. I think it's kind of funny, you know, Curt Schilling took some shots at Lou Piniella earlier this year. The Red Sox lead the American League by 8 hit batsmen over the second closest team in the league, which is the New York Yankees. Now some of that certainly can be attributed to Wakefield and his knuckleball dancing around, and occasionally a guy's going to get clipped by one of those, but take care of your own business.
Two strikeouts in the inning. Mitre cruising through four.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced nor retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and description of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
The daring mind of Ashton Kutcher. It's the new hit series, Beauty and the Geek. Faye can't help being beautiful. Faye can't help being brainy.
Beg your pardon. Okay, no, that's not gonna work.
But can they help each other?
These are things that I feel like you would look good in. You have to pretend that you are the most confident person in the entire world. Do not bring out a notepad.
Are you gonna make out with me or what?
The new hit series, Beauty and the Geek. Tonight at 7 on WGN, Chicago's WB.
Chevy's proud to be the number one selling passenger car brand. And we also have the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. We've always broken the rules. Now we're rewriting them. Introducing for the first time ever, the Chevy Employee Discount for everyone. You pay what we pay, not a cent more. Now get an 05 Malibu base sedan for $15,692 at participating dealers only. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. For a good, good.
Thinking about your ride? Here's your second chance. Play Illinois Lottery's Roll to Riches. Send in $30 worth of qualifying non-winning instant and online tickets. There's 20 golden keys that unlock 20 new cars. Pop your trunk to find $25,000 to $1 million inside. So go ahead, replay. Illinois Lottery. Have a ball.
Now the high-definition replay monitor in our broadcast booth provided by Sharp Electronics, where dads... A special Dads and Grads rebate currently available on the 26-inch Aquos model. Check out sharpusa.com or your local retailer for details.
Boy, you want to make Dad happy on Father's Day. There you go.
Blue Jays without a base runner against Sergio Mitre through four innings. The Cubs with two runs in the third against Roy Halladay. Ramirez sky-high to center for Vernon Wells. And one out. Halladay, coming into this start, had won five straight with two complete games and had allowed three earned runs in those five starts, covering almost 40 innings. Well, he's allowed two earned runs here today. So he's been very stingy. Pitch to Todd Walker misses. One ball, no strikes. Ninth start for Walker since coming off the DL on May 25th. He's hitting under 200 since coming off the DL, but does have a couple of home runs. Fouled away by Walker. There's Gary Matthews, Cubs first base coach. He actually did some radio for the Toronto Blue Jays a few years ago, and he wanted to send along his best wishes to Tom Cheek, Tom and his wife Shirley, as Adams throws out Walker. Tom, the original voice of the Toronto Blue Jays, and a great guy, and boy, everybody's pulling for him. His health has precluded him from working in the broadcast booth, but Sarge wanted to send along his best wishes to Tom and Shirley Cheek. It's been a tough time for the Cheek family. And we certainly send along our best wishes as well.
Absolutely. The brief time I spent in Toronto in 1989, Tom was one of the good guys. You really enjoyed being around him, and he obviously enjoyed being around the ballpark.
Boy, at one point, Tom Cheek called 4,306 consecutive regular season games with the Blue Jays. Fouled away by Dubois. And it's 1-1 on Jason. Here comes Halladay. Good breaker for a strike to make it 1-2. Halladay, born in Denver, Colorado. 22 wins in 03 to win the Cy Young, had no wins in April, yet he still led the league in victories that year.
You know, with the draft just finishing up today, does that not look like a scout? I mean, you know,
yeah,
the clipboard and a stopwatch on his lap, sitting behind home plate watching a ball game. Yeah, if you were going to cast a movie, that guy would be a scout.
A little bit of an Oscar Madison look as well.
I think the kid can hit.
And Todd Hollandsworth started the third inning with a double. Well, he had two RBIs last night without a hit, at a sac fly and an RBI ground out. And both RBIs tied the game. So I guess those would fall in the category of the productive outs that you were talking about. So you and Joe Garagiola used to really go at it, huh?
Well, I mean, it's not like we went at it, but he was of the opinion that, you know, it's either a hit or it's an out. There's no such thing as a good out. But, you know, I said if you advance a runner, you move him up 90 feet, set the table for the next guy coming up, then that's a good out.
Hudson has to hurry. He wanted to make a throw. Holly with his second hit today, an infield single. The inning's still alive. First and second.
Not how you hit him, it's where you hit him. Right off the plate, gets that high bounce in the air. If that ball had hit the dirt in front of home plate, it would have just died out there. Halladay would have been able to make an easy play, but because it hit the front of the plate, shot high in the air, Hudson with no play at first.
Barrett hit a rocket that was caught out in left center in the third inning. Two home runs last night for Michael. His third career two-homer performance.
Well, here's another guy that's very quietly making a case for that midsummer classic in Detroit this year, the All-Star game. Michael Barrett racking up offensive numbers. As the season has progressed, he's gotten better and better by the day.
Michael 8 for his last 17. The 2-0 to Barrett, and now 3-0. He's slugging Sergio Mitre is on deck.
Well, the double in his last at bat notwithstanding, I got to believe Michael Barrett has the green light here, 3-0, if he gets a pitch to his liking. 3-0 breaking ball with the pitcher on deck. But good discipline there from Michael Barrett. I guarantee you he had the green light, but he was looking for a fastball from the middle of the plate in, up a little bit, didn't get it, so he took the pitch.
Here comes a 3-1, got a piece of it. And the count is full. Roy Halladay, the third Blue Jay to win a Cy Young. Pat Henkin won it 96, and then the 2 years after that, Roger Clemens, 97 and 98. Halladay won 41 over a 2 year period, 02 and 03. 3-2 with the runners moving. Ground ball outside of third. That's foul. Somebody down there in the bullpen sneaking up to field that ball. It's Todd Wellemeyer, and he did not touch it. He was just waiting to make sure that it was foul.
Watch Michael Barrett's feet right here. As he gets ready to hit, you see him step forward in the batter's box. When a hitter does that, he's anticipating a breaking ball, and he got it and unfortunately just hooked it foul down that third baseline.
And he's hit by this 3-2 pitch to load him up.
That's that breaking ball that we saw him throw to Nathan Perez earlier in the ball game that almost went to the backstop. It just slipped out of his hand. No intent there. Very hot, muggy day. Sure the players are perspiring freely out there, and sometimes you get a little bit too much moisture on your fingertips and that ball just comes sliding out before you're ready for it.
Yeah, we're wearing it up here as well. I'll tell you what, we'll take it.
Well, as opposed to a month or so ago when we had every jacket we owned on and we were still freezing up here, I will take this any day.
Now, pitchers in particular love days like this. Doesn't take long to get loose. Pitchers seem to move a little bit more. When talking to a guy like Michael Wuertz, really feels like his slider's a lot better on a hot, muggy day. To Mitre to short. They're making good contact again. They will get the force play at second, and the Cubs leave them loaded. A couple of hits in the inning, 2-0.
Welcome to California.
We run.
We rip.
We fly.
We swing.
We believe.
We believe in Nirvana.
We rock.
And we've got our own motto.
Fans enjoying the weather today. 2-0 Cubs. Let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
On the WB Wednesday, the academically challenged team up with the socially challenged. Catch this summer's hottest new reality show, Beauty and the Geek. Tonight at 7 on WGN, Chicago's WB.
Sergio Mitre with two career wins in the big leagues, went six innings both times out. And both were last year on the road. He has retired 12 straight to start this one today. And he works through Eric Hinsky. Former 17th round pick of the Cubs out of Arkansas in 1998. Again, he's from Wisconsin. He grew up a Cubs fan. He was more of a Cubs fan than he was a Brewers fan. Cubs traded into Oakland in 2001 for Miguel Cairo and the rights to retain right-hander Scott Chasen. Hinsky then went on, and after getting dealt from the A's to the Blue Jays, he was the 2002 American League Rookie of the Year. Hit 279, 24 home runs, 84 RBIs. And he did it as a third baseman. Now he's at first base. He's done well in interleague play. Didn't attain the same level of consistency in 03 and 04 as he did in 02. Came in hitting 271. Ground ball moving Walker to his left. Sign up for a subscription to Vineline, the official monthly magazine of the Chicago Cubs. Vineline offers its readers exclusive player features, team analysis, and unparalleled minor league coverage every month. Subscription started just $24.95. Also check out the Sears Player of the Month recap every month from May to November. It's 800-248-9467, or you can visit Cubs.com to order Vineline today. Well, the outfielders have not had any action. None whatsoever.
Sergio Mitre could pull a Satchel Paige right here. Just call him into the dugout. Pitch with an infield behind him. He's throwing all ground balls. 10 ground balls, 3 strikeouts.
I mean, they've broken a sweat because it's hot. But they haven't had any chances.
Well, since they're not working defensively, they're doing all the offense. 4 of the hits in this game coming from the Cubs outfielders. The other hit coming from the pitcher Sergio Mitre. So he's letting the outfielders rest on defense so they can use it on offense.
See, 89, 90 degrees as Hill fouls that one off his front foot. Now, the scouting report on Aaron Hill is he's a contact hitter. I'll say 71 plate appearances, 3 strikeouts and 4 walks. So he puts the ball in play.
His approach is considerably different with nobody on base as opposed to RBI situations. We've seen him with runners in scoring position in this series really concentrate on hitting the ball up the middle of the field. So far in his first 2 at-bats here in the ballgame, really pulling off the ball, looking like he's trying to pull. Hit a ground ball down to Aramis Ramirez at third base back in the second inning and has pulled a couple pitches that direction again here in this at-bat.
Mitre's 3-2 pitch, high chopper, Ramirez with the throw, safe at first. Ramirez did all he could. The Baltimore chop base hit for Aaron Hill. And that's how the Blue Jays get their first base runner and hit today.
Well, much like Todd Hollandsworth's base hit back in the fourth inning, this ball hits the plate. You can see how high in the air it bounces. Ramirez has no choice but just to wait for it to come down. Still makes it a very close play over there at first base. Well, that's a shame. That's a tough way to lose a no-no.
In a perfect game into the fifth inning. Up Hudson with a runner at first and one out. So Mitre working from the stretch for the first time today. And that's one thing about a guy just cruising along is he has not had to work out of the stretch. So you hope he's able to maintain his rhythm with the first base runner.
Of course, as part of their pregame warm-ups, starting pitchers will throw a number of pitches out of the stretch position before going out to take the mound to start the game. But as you said, this is the first time he's been in the stretch since the first pitch of this ball game.
You know, Pedro Martinez had a no-hitter into the seventh last night. It was eventually broken up, I believe, on a home run from Chris Burke. Pedro, after the game, said he didn't know he had a no-hitter. He was just concentrating on each batter.
Liar.
Kind of tough to believe, but that's what he claims.
That's tough to believe. I mean, there's no question he was concentrating on every pitch and every batter, but geez, they got a great big scoreboard out there with a 15-foot-tall zero in the hits column. It's pretty tough to miss.
Yeah. Here's a 2-1. Derek Lee fires to second. That's all they'll get. Hudson running well, so Napi knew he wasn't going to be able to make a return throw. Mitre did get over to cover first.
Hey, remember the Cubs made an error on a similar play to this on the last road trip. Napi tried to make the return throw to Sergio Mitre covering the bag, and the throw was a little behind Mitre and opened the door for some runs to score. So that time, wisely, Napi Perez just made sure to stay on the bag at second base, get the force out, knowing that Orlando Hudson runs way too well to double up on that ball. What's that old cliche about? Don't try to do too much. You know, just take the out you're supposed to get. If it's going to take a miraculous play to get that second out, you're better off just holding on to the ball.
Russ Adams takes ball one. First round pick in 0-2 out of North Carolina. And again, he's a rookie. Aaron Hill, the third baseman, first round pick in 0-3. Adams, a 2-time All-State golfer and quarterback in high school. Thing you can say about golf, he can continue to play that. He's probably not playing football a whole lot these days, and we saw what happened to Lance Berkman in the offseason. He'll never play football again.
Not even flag football.
1-1. Bouncer foul. Huckabee, the catcher on deck. Hudson 4-for-5 and stolen bases. And on cue, Mitre throws over. Jammed in that time.
He fouled that ball off his left thigh. We've seen a lot of that this year. Get a look from our Southwest camera. They did.
Well, remember, was it Rich Aurelia did it? Called Dusty Baker. Claimed that's not possible to foul it off the back thigh, but we just saw it happen. I guess Sean Casey did it. I think it was in spring training. Rich Aurelia had done it when he was a Giant. He called Dusty immediately and said, see, it's not just me. So here is living proof that you can foul a ball off your back thigh. Sprayed foul. Now look at the perspiration on Russ Adams. That jersey is... got to weigh a couple of pounds right now. Another 2-2 in tight. Well, Mitre has not been afraid to throw in today.
That's part of the reason for his effectiveness. He's kept the Blue Jays from leaning out over the plate, hitting outside strikes to the opposite field. Something they did very effectively in the first two games of this series.
There goes Hudson on the 3-2, and he walked him. So the only base runners today for the Blue Jays, an infield hit and a walk. Mitre now facing a guy who's hitless in his last 18 at bats, Ken Huckabee. Another chopper, Ramirez charging, all kinds of time. Mitre getting out of it. They hit a walk, they strand two. It's still 2-0 Cubs. He's leading the Jays 2-0, game three of this series. And let's check out today's Walgreens Celebrity Bat Kids. Martin Just, 10 years old from Naperville, 14-year-old Julie Sipic from Lombard. Young Cub fans can get Celebrity Bat Kid contest details in this month's issue of Vineline. Top of the Cubs order, bottom of the fifth against Roy Halladay. Strike one on Perez. Bad timing. They had the banner out in support of Nafee. There it is. WGN, we got Nafee. Third ball for a strike. Well, they're going to get home tonight. Did we make it on TV? Yeah, a little bit late, but you made it. That's a great thing about videotape, though.
Mm-hmm.
Our crew saved them. Wind and a 1-2. Perez staying alive. Shoot us an email if you'd like. WGNCubsTVBooth@AOL.com. So right back to Halladay. He'll throw on to first. Well, Mark Pryor has been playing catch just to test his arm strength, keep it up, really. And the Cubs try to gauge where his elbow is. They have stressed that really it's just about keeping the shoulder, the arm ready. So when he is able to throw in earnest, that he doesn't have to start from ground zero. And Kerry Wood's case, he threw a sim game today, and all the reports were very positive.
Well, Woody had his game face on too. Boy, when he came off the mound back into the dugout, I was sitting there with Dick Pohl and asking how he was feeling. And geez, they're going to bite my head off. Pitching in a simulated game. Simulated anger.
1-1 to Patterson. Now it's 1-2 after that foul strike. RBI single for Corey on an 0-2 pitch in the third inning. Also stole a base. He's 1-for-2.
It's a little bit of the simulated game this morning for Kerry Wood. Actually put his road jersey on to go out there and pitch against some of the Cubs bench players. Enrique Wilson, Jose Macias. Patterson just gets a piece of another breaking ball to stay alive. In a little better mood now.
Struck him out swinging. Inside heat. And Corey missed it.
A pitch that Halladay's been trying to throw the last three pitches of the sequence down and in. It looked like a little bit of a cutter or maybe a baby slider, just a little movement in on Corey Patterson. The last two pitches he left up and over the plate, Corey was able to foul him off. But the last one he got down and in where he wanted it, and Corey swung right over the top of it.
Derek fairly quiet in the series. 2-for-10. But over his last 12, over 500 with 5 home runs, 13 RBIs. You know, he might win another player of the week. Deep to right for Derek Lee. That ball back. It'll one hop the door out there. And it's a double. So he just says that a quiet series, and he promptly doubles his 18th two-base hit. Comes with two outs here in the fifth.
Now, Reed Johnson has played left field the first two games of this series, playing right field today. Looked like he wanted no part of this ball hit down the right field line. Appeared he looked up into the sun and lost the ball momentarily and then just quits on it. The ball short hops the door out there in right field. An easy double for Derek Lee.
Now, Derek's already won the Player of the Week award twice, including the last one. A strike, and it's 1-1 on Ramirez, who's 2-for-6 in his career against Halladay, including the 0-for-2 today. On the ground, moving Hill to his left, pops him in, then throws him out. Two out double by Lee, but the Cubs fail to score. They lead 2-0.
Quake for more.
I would do anything for you.
Smallville at a special time. Tonight at 8 on WGN.
Well, the Cubs lead 2-0, and Sergio Mitre has done it all on the mound and at the plate. He's allowed just a hit and a walk, and it was an infield hit.
Well, you know, you go into the series, as you said earlier, and you try to pick, this game we might win, this game, maybe we have to battle against Halladay, but Sergio Mitre has been up to the task today. He's made a lot of good pitches. His defense in the infield has been extremely busy, and he's swung the bat like he means it. He's hit a couple balls right on the button, including a double to drive in a run.
And he's facing Halladay here in the sixth inning. There's two base runners for the Blue Jays. And again, the Cubs with an off day tomorrow for the first time in almost three full weeks. Mentioned the Cubs 1-4 in interleague play, and all those games here at home, the Blue Jays 4-1 against the other league. 2-1 now on the pitcher. This is the first time ever the Blue Jays have played here at Wrigley Field. It'll be the same for the Red Sox. Coming up this weekend, Red Sox and Cubs met up in the 1918 World Series, but the home games for the Cubs in that series were played at Comiskey because it was a bigger venue. And we'll hit the air at 12:30. The return of the Red Sox with Dan Rohn live from Wrigley. Leadoff man at 1 o'clock. First pitch around 1:20. And it will be Bronson Arroyo, a right-hander, against Greg Maddux. Red Sox won that series in 1918, 4-2. Took them a long time to win their next one, but they won it last year. Reed Johnson on deck. Called strike three. Good comeback by Mitre. This Father's Day, June 19th, the Cubs will offer Cub fans an opportunity of a lifetime. Just say, hey, Dad, want to have a catch at Wrigley? Spend an hour on Father's Day playing catch in the outfield and running the bases of beautiful Wrigley Field. You'll also receive a commemorative T-shirt, a photograph, and lunch in the Friendly Confines Cafe. Tickets are $150 per person. Call 773-404-CUBS. All proceeds benefit Cubs Care, fund of the McCormick Tribune Foundation. Johnson is 0 for 2. Ball one. And of course, with the off days coming up, Kerry Wood's return hopefully not too far away. A couple of guys in Mitre and Karanka were kind of going start to start. In fact, Sunday's game against Boston, listed as TBA, would be John Karanka's night, but the Cubs could go with Glendon Rush instead with the off day coming up tomorrow.
And don't think for a minute that Sergio Mitre and John Karanka don't know the situation. Basically, every time out there, they're auditioning for their next start. And so far, Sergio has risen to the occasion here today.
And it's not just Wood and a little bit down the road prior, but, you know, a guy in Jerome Williams who at some point here in the middle of the summer may be ready. He's at AAA right now. That's a strike. And as Johnson went around, Tim Cheetah with the call.
Definitely that bat gets out in front of home plate there through the hitting area before he can hold up.
And Jerome Williams with some previous big league time. The Cubs monitoring his starts. And left-hander Rich Hill has gone from double-A to triple-A. And Bob, that's always a good situation when guys are getting pushed, whether it's a platoon situation in the big leagues, whether it's a young position player with a guy struggling up here. There's always motivation, somebody right behind you. The 3-2 is hit into center. So first time a Blue Jay has hit one into the outfield, and it comes here in the sixth inning with one out.
Now, this has always been a game about what have you done for me lately. Until you have an established track record at the major league level and have proven you can compete at this level at a high level, you're always going to be pushed by guys who play your position in the minor leagues.
Play another good example of what we're talking about after this pitch to Catalanato. Jason Dubois has been the regular left fielder for about a month. But lately we've seen Todd Hollandsworth get some starts. Now they're both in the lineup today because Burnitz is out, getting a day of rest. But Dusty has given Jason Dubois a lot of playing time. But if at some point he wants to go back to Hollandsworth full time, I mean, guys are going to have to produce. It comes down to production dictating who's going to play the most.
Absolutely.
And I think in Jason's case, more than anything else, it's just a matter of making some adjustments at this point of the season. He's been exposed. The league has seen him. The advanced scouts have seen him. A lot of videotape out there already. They found the holes in his swing, and opposing pitchers now know how to go after Jason Dubois. Now it's a question of him making the adjustment, getting to those pitches, closing those holes, if he wants to remain the everyday left fielder.
One, Catalanato is inside. And look, a manager wants a player to relax and just go out and do his thing. But there's a fine line, isn't there, between being relaxed and maybe being lackadaisical. You just can't ever count on anything beyond really today when you're a young player in this game.
Well, the manager would like to be relaxed from time to time, too. And if you do your job, that will let the manager relax, and he's more likely to leave you in the lineup.
Walker will take the short throw and get Catalanato. So Johnson, his second Blue Jay to reach second base today. He's there with two down here in the sixth.
Boy, now Mark O'Neill, the Cubs trainer, running out to the mound. Check on Sergio Mitre. I didn't see anything after that delivery. I mean, as soon as that out was recorded at first base, O'Neill was out of the dugout and running across that Cubs on deck circle out onto the field. Now Dale Scott will let the Blue Jays know that that did not count as an official visit to the mound. That's why the umpire always goes out there. We get another look at it here. Mitre starts to break towards first base on that ball hit to his left. Didn't really see anything in that replay that would indicate what the problem is, but as I started to mention, the home plate umpire immediately goes to the mound when the trainer and the pitching coach come out to make sure that they're not talking about strategy. It's strictly a medical visit to the mound, and if in the umpire's judgment that's all it was, it does not count as a visit to the mound by the pitching coach.
Good play by Ramirez. The throw to first in time to get Wells. Probably saved a run. 2-0.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball and the Chicago Cubs.
Batting and leading 2-0. Hey, coming up Friday, first 20,000 fans will receive a scratch and win card, and 100 random winners will take home a majestic 2005 Nomar Garciaparra home jersey. Compliments of MBNA. Fans are encouraged to hold on to their cards for second chance drawings throughout the game. For complete rules, visit Cubs.com. Nomar expected to be here for this weekend series. Of course, he's on the disabled list right now after groin slash abdominal surgery. Todd Walker grounds to short. Adams with a strike over to first.
After finishing that last half inning, Sergio Mitre came off the field, some high fives from his defenders, and drops off his hat and his glove, and you can see Mark O'Neill signaling down in the tunnel. Yeah, like we said before, not sure exactly what the problem is at this point. Didn't really see anything obvious as Mitre was pitching in that last half inning.
And the Cubs have made Roy Halladay work. With one out in the sixth, he's over 90 pitches. I mean, he went nine innings two starts ago and threw 99. And that two-hitter against the Twins.
His four complete games this year, the 99 pitches in his last one, 97, 115, and 117. He's been very efficient for the most part this year.
Two balls, no strikes on Dubois. We were talking kind of in general terms earlier. about young players getting pushed by others at this level. You know, it bears mentioning, Jason Dubois has just really handled everything this year to a T. And talk about rookies and young players. You like them to be seen and not heard that much in the clubhouse. He has just put his head down, has worked very hard. And whenever he's been asked about regular playing time, he just says, I'm just going to go out and do my thing and let everything else fall into place. And that's exactly what Dusty Baker likes to hear from a young player. Swing and a miss and a strikeout.
And certainly there are areas of his game that could stand some improvement, cutting down on strikeouts, narrowing down his strike zone a little bit, not chasing so many pitches, taking a few more walks. But, you know, his aggressiveness is part of his attractiveness to the Cubs. He lets that bat go. He takes a hack at the ball when he puts it in play. He usually hits the ball extremely hard. But you're right, he hasn't changed anything. Early in the season, he was a backup player, pinch hitter, getting an occasional spot start here and there, and he was taking a lot of extra BP in the cage every day, and he continues to take a lot of extra BP in the cage.
I got a great email recently from 7-year-old Tyler Nathoff, who wrote about his 9-year-old brother Cody, who's a big Cubs fan and has been in the hospital for quite some time. And Tyler wanted us to say hello to Cody. So, Cody, we hope you're watching today and get well soon. Hudson to Hinsky to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Cubs. 2-0 they lead.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
I'll get the seats, you get the stroller.
Budweiser Game Time fan can on a rooftop kind of day at Wrigley.
There's room enough for you.
Tops are full today. Carole King with a remake of Up on the Roof.
Give me a moment to gather myself, please.
You okay?
Yeah.
2-0 Cubs. You're a big Carole King fan. Come on. Eric Hinsky is 0-2. Outside corner. Mitre still in there. Remember, the trainer and the pitching coach came out in the last inning. He saw something and he went into the clubhouse between innings. He has pitched a gem today. Ground ball left side, Ramirez to lead. Will Ullman, the lefty, is up for the Cubs.
You got to believe that's just a precautionary measure. Whatever is bothering Mitre out there on the mound, if he went out this half inning and started to struggle early, thus he just wanted to make sure he had somebody close and ready to come into this ball game if necessary. But so far Mitre gets one quick out here in the seventh.
We heard all these rumors about, well, it may rain this afternoon. Hear that a lot of days like this, though, with the capricious nature of Chicago weather.
Ooh.
Inside on Aaron Hill. WGNTV.com/baseball blog or WGN baseball blog, brought to you by Dunkin' Donuts. We will put all the words of the day on the blog. So if you miss one, and we hope you don't, but if you do, we'll put it on there with the definition as well. We'll even use it in a sentence. Swing and a miss. Glenn Beckert coming up, by the way, with Take Me Out to the Ball Game. Two outs here in the seventh.
whatever's bothering Mitre, it hasn't changed his stuff or the movement on that hard sinker down and into Hill right there. Boy, he is a man on a mission today. He's got great stuff.
Strike on Hudson. We showed you the two career wins for Sergio Mitre, and he had gone six innings in both of those wins. Pitch number 100 on the afternoon for Mitre. Well, he has just simply been better thus far than Roy Halladay. No question about it. And he also was a big part of the two-run third, RBI double to get it started. And then he scored on the Patterson RBI single. So he was a part of both runs. And the 3-1 pitch. Hudson with a big swing. It's 3-2. Yeah, Cubs all-star second baseman Glenn Beckert, four-time all-star, 69-72. Three-two pitch, and Hudson stays alive. Let's pause briefly for station identification.
You're watching Chicago's official summer baseball station, WGN.
Here comes Mitre again. He struck him out. A shutout through seven. It's 2-0.
Today's guest conductor for Take Me Out to the Ball Game, welcome former Cub All-Star second baseman Glenn Beckert.
It's nice here to be with you great fans. It's nice to see the Cubs winning. So help me out, fans. A one, a two, a three. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I ever get back, and it's root for the Cubbies. If they don't win, it's a shame. For it's one, two, three strikes, you're out at the old ball game. It's will be the year.
He's the world's best dad. So for Father's Day, give him the world's best shave, Gillette M3 Power. You could win a trip for four to Madrid to meet one of the world's best soccer players, David Beckham. M3 Power from Gillette.
Sergio Mitre with a two-hit shutout through seven. Looks like he's done as Michael Barrett looks at strike one. Jose Macias in the on-deck circle in Mitre's spot. Boy, he was terrific today. Glenn Beckert, former Cubs all-star second baseman, in the booth with us here in the bottom of the seventh. Great job of Take Me Out to the Ball Game. And let's see, you live in Florida. Feels like you're in Florida right now, doesn't it, Glenn?
It actually feels warmer. I think you have more humidity here.
Boy, what an outing for Sergio Mitre. You saw Dusty Baker chatting with him. Look at the numbers on Sergio Mitre today. Yeah, you put the fan right next to the pitcher who goes seven shutout innings. Halladay with the pitch. Barrett laid off the curveball. So, Glenn, your thoughts on this Cubs team? Of course, had a great West Coast trip. Well, you go 6-1 through L.A. and San Diego.
That's very, very
impressive.
Good. I mean, it's outstanding. Let's hope they get it together. When they get some of the healthy pitchers back, it could be the year. The actual season starts this weekend. Bob, you know about that, being a manager.
Oh, yeah. You know, and you, I think you hit the nail on the head. You get some healthy guys back in that pitching rotation. Maybe at some point in the second half, Nomar comes back and contributes the way we know he can. It's a whole different story.
So Michael Barrett, with his first hit today, is fourth the last two games. And time to have a ball with the Illinois Lottery. All right, you can do some self-analysis here on the first pitch today.
Oh, geez. That's an awesome.
Nice job. Oh. Did you do that on camera? I hope so. Flexing his muscles up here in the booth.
You didn't need a strong arm to play second. You
no,
just had to be quick.
I've had a torn rotator cuff for years, and as long as you can swing a golf club, even though I played on a rotunda with a group of friends in Florida, and it's.
Hill will go to second in a very good scoop.
But as long as you can do that, you don't. Once you turn 65, you don't need to throw a ball anymore.
It was a nice play by Russ Adams covering second. Glenn Beckert
flashing a little leather right there.
Those were the days.
On the Gold Glove in 1971. So what do you think? I mean, when you see footage of yourself, I mean, do you think about the team? Do you think about that particular play? I mean, what kind of memories does that bring up
you
for
think
you?
Think about if you had a younger brother, that's what he looked like. No, you think about things, and to this now you're at an age where you think, did I actually do things like that? And Bobby, you were a good, excellent player. You recall doing things, and you see, try to do it now, it's not possible.
Not possible. Your body doesn't move quite the same now as it used to. But I got to tell you, Beck, those teams that you played for with the Cubs in the late 60s, early 70s are as close a group of players as I think I have ever seen. You guys all stay in touch with each other. You're constantly in communication.
We're great friends with each other. In fact, I just saw Billy Williams there. And it's a matter of, we'll take a shortstop second baseman like Don Kessinger and I were together for 9 years. I don't think you're going to see that much anymore.
One and nothing on Nathy Perez. Macias on the move, and the Cubs will. Oh, that's an out. And a double play. I was going to say they're going to stay out of the double play, but the tag and the throw, that was a pretty nifty defensive play there to end the inning. Glenn Becker, thanks so much for the time. Let's check out how this inning ends. And Orlando Hudson with a Glenn Becker sort of play to turn it 4-3, inning over.
The luxury sedan. Designed to outperform. Introducing the all-new M from Infiniti.
Hey, thanks to Glenn Beckert for stopping by, and a very nifty play on a 4-3 double play turned by Orlando Hudson to get the Blue Jays out of the bottom of the seventh. And then Michael Wuertz pitching here in the eighth against Russ Adams. And again, the story of the day today, Sergio Mitre, 7 innings, 2 hits. In those 7 innings, the Blue Jays hit one ball out of the infield. That was a Reed Johnson single to center in the 6th inning. One and two on Adams. Switch hitter Greg Zahn is on deck in Huckabee's spot. Popped him up. Back of first, Lee and Walker. Todd calling off the first baseman makes a catch. So Zahn will pinch hit and stay in and catch for the Blue Jays. The announcer, what is, okay, are sexy. The announcers are sexy. You know, big Pat Ron fans.
They know how to get on TV.
Here's Greg Zahn. Greg Zahn with the long sleeve undershirt today, and it's only 90 here at Wrigley.
Somebody got frostbite here last night, I guess.
Jeez.
Black long sleeves on a day like this.
Looks like he has two undershirts on, actually. Looks like I see a couple of collars under the jersey. Fly ball center field. It is deep. Patterson took a look back. Not going to get to the track. Two down. Well, maybe that was a necklace for Greg Zahn. Well, you put three shirts on today, and you're going to lose about 10 pounds. Shea Hillenbrand will bat for Roy Halladay, who is very good as well. It tells you how great Mitre was. He was better than Halladay, who gave up two runs on seven hits in his seven innings.
Yeah, really, the Cubs were able to do exactly what we talked about at the beginning of the show, take advantage of any opportunities that you have against Halladay. The leadoff double by Hollandsworth in the third inning, followed by the Mitre double, followed by the Patterson single. They cashed in the runners that they got on base. And so far, Cubs have been able to make those two runs stand up.
Will Oman, the lefty, and the closers, Ryan Dempster on the left. Well, let's see. We have seen Hinsky, Hill, Hudson, Huckabee, Halladay, and now Hillenbrand for the Blue Jays. Three and one. Well, you don't want to put the tying run at the plate with a guy on deck who has hit four home runs in five career games against the Cubs. Reed Johnson. That's exactly what happens here with two outs as Hillenbrand draws the walk. Second walk issued by Cubs pitchers today. Reed Johnson with nine hits and 22 tries against the Cubs in his career. Got a triple, scored twice last night, hit a three-run homer among his two hits in the opener. One for three today. The pitch from Wuertz stays high. All right, Rothschild coming out for an official visit. While we have the opportunity, let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
On the WB Wednesday, a love potion stirs up feelings between the football players and the cheerleaders. Catch the hit WB series Smallville at a new time. Tonight at 8 on WGN, Chicago's WB.
Cubs trying to salvage the finale here today. They have not been swept at home three times. They have won the final game to avoid a three-game sweep here at home against the Padres, Phillies, and the White Sox. And they're leading here late against the Blue Jays. Cubs right now 15-14 at home, just a game over 500. They're two over on the road. Two and one. Cubs started the day 7.5 out, losing a couple of games in the standings to the Cardinals over the last 2 days. In second place in the National League Central. Reed Johnson, foul tipping for strike two, 2-2. Blue Jays in third in the American League East, 4.5 back of the Orioles. The Blue Jays right now 2.5 games ahead of the Yankees. Wuertz with a 2-2, another one high. He's been elevating his pitches to the last couple of hitters. Hillenbrand running on the 3-2. He struck him out. Got the slide piece to work. And he strikes out Johnson. We'll head to the bottom of the eighth. Cubs will try to add some more insurance.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Nonstop service to 59 destinations all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
To more places than ever before. America is your backyard. Southwest Airlines, we're taking low fares farther.
You are now free to move about the country.
At Lexus, we developed an air purification system that uses ultraviolet technology and micron filters to help eliminate any odors and airborne irritants from the cabin, even pollen. Because we don't want anything, no matter how small, to spoil your drive.
For my sport, the only sunscreen is Coppertone Sport.
It's non-greasy, so I won't lose my grip.
And it doesn't run in my eyes, no matter how hard I sweat.
Coppertone Sport, high-performance sunscreens.
New refreshing blueberry-flavored iced coffee from Dunkin' Donuts. It's exhilaration in a cup. Dunkin' Donuts, bring yourself back.
Closed captioning for Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
2-0 Cubs is a bat here in the eighth inning. Got the bow tie, the suspenders on today. Greg Zahn is back of the plate, so a new battery for the Blue Jays. Right-hander Vinny Chulk facing Corey Patterson. Cubs lead by two, and ball one on Patterson. Corey batting second today. RBI single for him in the third inning. He has struck out twice. And the numbers for Chulk.
Pitched a 1-2-3 eighth inning in the first game of the series and then gave up a leadoff home run to Aramis Ramirez in the ninth inning. The only run the Cubs scored in that ball game as they dropped one to the Blue Jays 4-1.
Going into this game, the Cubs had out hit the Blue Jays in this series 18-17 despite losing the first two. They're out hitting them 7-2 today. Broken bat, just foul. Down the right field line for Patterson. Barrel ended up near the second base position. Inspected by Orlando Hudson.
Once again, bat just explodes. The barrel ends up out in the hole between first and second base. The ball didn't go too much further, but it was closer to the foul line.
Cubs trying to get to four games over on the year and three games over all time against the American League. Right now 61-59 in interleague play. 1-2 pitch is away on Patterson. He'll be followed by Lee and then Ramirez here in the eighth inning. And right now things setting up for Ryan Dempster, the closer in the ninth. Wuertz with a scoreless eight after Mitre's stellar seven innings. Bob, I have a feeling tomorrow's off day will be a little bit different than a normal off day in that it's been 20 full days without one. And while a lot of guys will spend time with their families, I can't imagine they're going to be doing a whole lot tomorrow. Just simply getting rest.
Just get some rest. little family time.
Play by Hudson on the flip to Hinsky. Don't miss Lion Power Day Tuesday, June 14th, as the Cubs take on the Marlins at 7:05. First 5,000 fans age 13 and younger will receive a Cubs fan Hubert plush toy. This limited edition doll is the official mascot Lion of Harris Bank. That's Lion Power Day Tuesday, June 14th.
What's the name of that lion again?
Cubs fan Hubert.
Obviously a Jose Macias fan as well. Look like jersey number one.
Average holding at 380 for Derek Lee. He was asked the other day if he's aware of his numbers. He said, oh yeah. And I think some were surprised that he knows what his numbers are. I mean, most guys do, right?
Yeah, sure. I mean, you know, it's in the newspaper every day. It's in the media notes every day. It's on the scoreboard every at bat. So it's, you know, it's pretty hard not to know what you're hitting. But, you know, as far as in relation to the history of the game and other Triple Crown winners and this late in the season with this high of an average, you know, the minutiae that we dwell upon, he's probably not aware of any of that, but he knows what he's hitting.
Goes the other way. Johnson is there to make the catch. Well, I'm sure a lot of people going up to me, hey, you know you're hitting 380? yeah.
I do now. You know, but as far as day games, night games, you know, all the other things that we keep track of in this game, you know, they know they're either doing well or they're not doing so well. They couldn't tell you their exact numbers against righties and their exact numbers against lefties. Yeah, I know I'm hitting lefties better than righties, but couldn't tell you the numbers. But the overall average, the overall home runs, RBIs, those kind of things, obviously public knowledge, they're printed, they're put on the scoreboard, so it's hard to avoid them.
The 0-1-2, Ramirez is fouled off. Well, I'm sure you played with guys, and I've been around players who have asked, who's pitching today for the other team? Oh, is that guy a righty or a lefty? And these are guys who hit 300. I mean, some guys just show up and play. They don't overanalyze anything. And yet, you know, they're all-star caliber players, so it does happen.
Well, I mean, right up until the national anthem is played, they don't know who you're facing, whether he's a righty or lefty. Makes no difference. He's going to have to throw the ball over the plate in the strike zone to get me out anyway, and if he does that, I'm going to hit it. Other guys, a lot of homework. They want to know everything about that opposing pitcher. Breaking ball just breaks around the plate, doesn't quite get to that inside corner.
Lined and caught on the dive by Aaron Hill. Boy, he's been impressive in this series, certainly offensively, and makes a nice diving play. We will head to the ninth, 2-0 Cubs.
I can't believe Kyle turned down these tickets.
I know, right? Let's hit him up.
Hey, that's your apartment. That's your Bud Light. That's your girlfriend.
Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here.
Sharon?
Yeah, she's sharing all right.
At Menards, we're dedicated to service, quality, and providing the best selection. Surround your home with the natural beauty of cedar fence. Pre-assembled Gothic panels are $19.99 each. Lattice top panels only $49.99. Protect all your exterior wood surfaces with Flood CWF UV. It penetrates wood fibers to block moisture and harmful UV rays, only $12.97 a gallon. Plus, don't pay till next spring with your Menards big card.
Save big money at Menards.
Polite society tells us that it's rude to stare. But then along came the 2005 V6 Nissan Altima. With a redesigned interior, a state-of-the-art navigation system and satellite radio, and a sleek, refined exterior. So go ahead, stare. Frankly, It'd be rude not to.
Summerland is back with 5 fresh new episodes.
It feels like anything's possible.
It's the Summerland summer premiere.
It's about our future.
Brayden, and if anyone ever finds out...
You hurt a lot of people because you lied.
Get out of here.
Get out!
The summer premiere of Summerland. Monday night at 8 on WGN.
Yeah, it's a Halladay for a Cubs win over at High Tops. 2-0 Cubs, ninth inning. And right now, a two-hit shutout. Jeremy Burnett comes in to play right field. Todd Hollandsworth moves over and now mans left. And the closer, Ryan Dempster. Canadian born. He used to watch the Blue Jays on CBC. And he faces the Blue Jays here in the ninth today. Lewis, first save opportunity, 6 for his last 6. And the pitch to Frank Catalanato is a strike. Now, Omen and Dempster, along with Carlos Zambrano, with a 5-hit shutout on Sunday in San Diego. Glennon with a complete game shutout. Glennon Rush on Thursday in San Diego. And they're trying to team up Wuertz and Dempster with Mitre here today. Cubs with 4 shutouts on the year.
This is one of those save opportunities. Dempster's definitely going to have to earn it, working his way through the middle of the Blue Jays lineup. Catalanato batting over 300 coming into play today. Then Wells and Hinsky. Sometimes you can get a save opportunity, be facing the bottom of the order, maybe after a team's bench has been a little bit depleted, they don't have any pinch hitters, and it can be a relatively easy 1-2-3 inning, but you're going to have to work to get this one.
And Wells on deck. A lot of home run power for him. The 3-1. Catalanato deposits it into center for a leadoff single. So the tying run will come to the plate here in the ninth. And it'll bring up Wells, who has 13 home runs on the year. 0 for 3 today. Ball 1. Ryan Dempster from British Columbia. Corey Koski, who's on the disabled list for the Blue Jays, is from Manitoba. So when he signed with the Blue Jays, coming back to Canada to play for the team he grew up rooting for. Dempster ahead of Wells, 1-2. Catalanato, the runner at first with nobody out. Struck him out swinging. That's out number 1 here in the ninth.
Couple of real good breaking balls to finish the sequence. Good, sharp, late breaking slider started down the heart of the plate. From our Southwest Plainview camera, you can see that ball work toward the outside corner. Well, swings right over the top.
Facing Eric Hinsky. 3 ground outs for Hinsky. Yeah. 2-0. I asked Ryan the other day, who is your favorite Blue Jay? He said, well, Kelly Gruber. Liked watching him.
Played with Kelly Gruber back in 89 briefly. Had a couple of great seasons for the Blue Jays.
2-1. Blake Mosby. Boy, a lot of guys you played with, he mentioned.
He didn't mention me.
I'm speechless. You know, he probably did. I mean, you know he loves you. Come on.
You'd have to be real lucky to have seen me play in my days with the Blue Jays. Yeah.
Caught the corner.
But especially being a pitcher, some of the pitching staffs back in those days for the Blue Jays with Dave Steeb and Jimmy Key and Tom Henke.
Two, two, and he strikes out Hinsky. Some deep counts here for Ryan. And after the leadoff single by Catalanato, two straight strikeouts.
Actually, that's the same pitch he struck out Vernon Wells with. This time he throws it to a left-handed hitter, starts it over the heart of the plate, dive bombs it down and in. Hinsky swings right over the top of it. Well, obviously the hitter's just not picking up the rotation on that pitch. Dempster executing absolutely perfect strike three pitches.
Up down the heart of the plate to Aaron Hill. Wind has turned just a little bit. Hasn't been blowing that hard today, but now blowing in from left.
Mother Nature cooperating with the Cubs' attempt to nail down a victory here.
One and two. $38,086 near the friendly confines today. Two, two, and it's full. Hempster has worked hard against all the hitters in this inning. Orlando Hudson watching from the on deck circle. Dempster would rather not face him.
And with the tying run at the plate, Cubs defensively in the outfield playing extremely deep in their no doubles defense. Don't really care too much about that lead runner, but they definitely want to keep the hitter off of second base.
The 3-2 with the runner moving, and he walked him. Hill represents a tying run at first base, first and second for Hudson. Again, we're on the air Friday with a return of the Red Sox special 12:30 with Dan Rohn. Rob and I will take over at 1 o'clock with the leadoff man and the first pitch at 1:20. Throwing a strike. Cubs looking again for their fifth shutout. They try to hang on here today. The kick and the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. 2-2. One strike away again.
That's a good pitch to Hudson. He does not have home run power. If you can get him to chase a fastball up in the zone, even if he makes contact, it's probably going to be a lazy fly ball to the outfield, wind blowing in slightly.
And he struck him out. Dempster with three strikeouts here in the ninth. Boy, he had to work hard. Gave up a couple of base runners, strands them both. And three pitchers combined on a three-hit shutout today. Sergio Mitre with his first win of the year, and he outduels Roy Halladay. Final pitch of the afternoon. Great location. Dempster with three strikeouts in the ninth inning. So Mitre with the game-winning RBI back in the third inning. Cubs scored two in the inning. That was it for the scoring. We'll be back to Wrigley.
Tonight, the WB kicks off with the new hit series from Ashton Kutcher, Beauty and the Geek.
We're soldiers, we're warriors. Ow, my ankle.
America and the critics agree, it's sexy, uplifting, with a big heart.
Beauty is so much more than skin deep.
The new hit, Beauty and the Geek, followed by Smallville.
Tonight at 7 on WGN. Moving Forward is the number one selling car in America. Moving Forward is an SUV with the lowest fuel cost in its class. And Moving Forward is a great value on any of Toyota's award winners at the Toyota Sales Drive. Visit your Toyota dealer now for 1.9 financing or 750 cash back on Sienna or 800 cash back on Highlander. Hurry for great selection, outstanding values, and award-winning quality at the Toyota Sales Drive. Now that's Moving Forward. Toyota.
Hey guys, listen up! Someone leave their lunch at the last rest stop. There's a sandwich and oh, we got a Pepsi. Still cold. Name on the back says Spartacus. Is there a Spartacus here to claim this?
I'm Spartacus.
I'm Spartacus.
I'm Spartacus.
I'm Spartacus.
I'm Spartacus. I'm Spartacus. I'm Spartacus.
LaSalle Bank, we believe when a bank is part of the community, more is possible.
2-0, the final. Mitre, Wuertz, and Dempster combining on the three-hitter. Ryan Dempster with us on the field. Ryan, you had to work hard in that ninth inning. You threw 25 pitches, but you struck out three, and man, you've saved seven straight.
Yeah, you know, this is a big game for us. You know, just when you go against a guy like Halladay like that, and you know, already losing the first two games of the series, to come out with a win like this was huge. And you know, it was a little bit tiring at the end there, but you know, it was nice to get the job done and get out here with a win.
You know, Ryan, I know you try to get the job done every time you take the mound, but is there a little extra pressure when your starter Sergio Mitre pitched as good as he did in the ball game today? You really want to nail that one down.
Well, you know, absolutely. I think especially being a guy who started before, you really appreciate that when a guy comes in. And you know, Wuertz did a heck of a job in the eighth, and then to close it out in the ninth for him and get the win. And he pitched his tail off. He bounced back from you know, from a rough one in San Diego, and went against probably the best pitcher in the American League, and won a 2-0 ball game against him. So you got to tip your hat off to Serge.
Well, now you're doing it in short spurts as a closer, but do you like interleague play, and do you like facing guys that you haven't seen before?
I think it's mixed emotions. You know, obviously when we're sitting there playing the Blue Jays, Yankees, and Red Sox, it's not an easy schedule. But, you know, when you face these guys, I think sometimes it can play into a little bit of your advantage, especially if you're locating your pitches, just because hitters haven't seen you and they haven't had really a chance to adjust, especially only throwing one inning.
And a final question, Ryan, we talked about it earlier. Tomorrow, first off day in basically 3 weeks, and we theorize that guys are going to spend some family time and not do a whole lot tomorrow. It's been a long time since your last off day.
Yeah, you know, I think we had it was like 20 in a row.
Yep.
So this will be a nice little off day because we got a big series coming up this weekend, and you know, get some rest and relaxation, but not too much because we got to be ready to go again Friday against the Red Sox.
All right, Demp, nice going today. We appreciate the time.
Thanks, guys.
That's Ryan Dempster. 3 strikeouts in the ninth inning. Wells with a runner at first. Hinsky, and then with 2 men on, Orlando Hudson, 2 ended. 2-0 Cubs the final. More to come from Wrigley Field.
Two teams of Clydesdales, 3,000 miles apart. One is coming from the west, the other from the east. This summer, Budweiser is traveling across this great nation, stopping to salute our country's everyday heroes, the men and women who make us proud to call America our home. When our Clydesdales eventually meet in the heartland to celebrate our freedom, we will once again remember those who serve all of us. At Budweiser, we take pride in our products and our country. American-owned, born here, brewed here. Budweiser.
I'll get the seats, you get the stroller.
Stow-and-go seating and storage. Exclusively in the 2005 Grand Caravan, the only minivan with 2 rows of folding floor seats.
Honey, you coming?
So you're not gonna talk. Then we're gonna talk.
Not my minutes, man.
Happy birthday, Nana. Dry cleaning, is that deductible?
Thank you for holding.
Peak hours.
Hang it up!
In a land far, far away.
Hello? Department of Motor Vehicles.
Never enough minutes on your wireless plan? Come to T-Mobile and get the most whenever minutes.
More minutes? Thanks.
You're welcome.
Now get the most whenever minutes guaranteed. 1,000 for just $39.99.
T-Mobile. Get more minutes.
2 runs, 7 hits, no errors for the Cubs. No runs, just 3 hits for the Blue Jays. Sergio Mitre with his best performance as a big leaguer. 7 shutout innings, gave up 2 hits. Only 1 ball was hit into the outfield by the Blue Jays in the first 7 innings. He walked 1 and 6 strikeouts for Sergio. And our bud play of the game is going to be the offense from Sergio. He had the game-winning RBI, put the Cubs on the board with an RBI double, his first career ribby in the third inning.
After the leadoff double by Hollandsworth, an out, and then Mitre followed with a double of his own to drive home really the only run he would need in this ballgame.
So our next telecast, the Red Sox come to Wrigley for the first time ever. That'll be Friday, 12:30 for the pregame. Sox and the Cubs from Wrigley. Off day tomorrow for the Cubs, and they'll get revved up for that big matchup on Friday. Arroyo against Maddox. Ryan Dempster has saved 7 in a row as he has shored up that ninth inning for the Chicago Cubs. Final score from Wrigley, Cubs 2, Toronto nothing. We'll be right back.
Exclusive rear-wheel active steer designed for more precise handling. The luxury sedan designed to outperform. Introducing the all-new M from Infiniti.
He's the world's best dad. So for Father's Day, give him the world's best shave. Gillette M3 Power. You could win a trip for 4 to Madrid to meet one of the world's best soccer players, David Beckham. M3 Power from Gillette.
Different models with EPA highway ratings of 30 or more miles per gallon. So no matter how high gas prices get, you can keep moving forward.
It's the hot thing in activewear. Bengay's Ultra Strength Pain Relieving Pack. Now even stronger for deep heating relief. And it lasts up to 8 hours. try the Ultra Strength Bengay Pain Relieving Patch. It's what's hot in pain relief.
A remarkably spacious cabin designed to breathe.